Rick, we didn't get to it in the last segment, but I wanted to let people update to you. Now you're the special envoy to Serbia and Kosovo and the Balkans. And unfortunately, like we've seen with the Abraham Accords that we were talking about, the Biden team not continuing to cultivate that historic new working relationship.
Yeah, look, the Biden team has been MIA in the Balkans, and now what we're seeing is a lack of leadership. We've had over the last couple of days some incidents at the border, violence at the border between Serbia and Kosovo. There are local elections in Kosovo on Sunday, and so the political leadership in Pristina are trying to manipulate this by inflaming some of the tensions in order to look strong. I would urge the leaders in Pristina to abide by the Brussels agreement, to do everything they can to reject violence. I would urge the leadership in Belgrade, the Serbian leaders, to continue working with the United States and reject moves by Russia and China. They're offering enticing deals with Serbia, and Serbia must move away from Russia and China and continue their relationship with the United States. And lastly, I would just say the Biden team needs to stop deferring to the EU and to Brussels on everything in the Balkans, because we know that the EU is analysis paralysis. They're not going to move quickly. And just yesterday, we saw the Biden administration move to say, we're working with the EU on the increase attacks between Serbia and Kosovo at the border. This is not leadership. This is a way to another reason that Biden is weak. Add this to the long list of Biden problems where they fail to understand the moment and they fail to step up and take leadership. They should have a presidential envoy for the Balkans. We don't have an ambassador right now in Pristina, Kosovo. The Senate should move quickly to confirm Jeff Hovenier, who is our U.S. ambassador to Kosovo nominee. Jeff is a career foreign service officer, would do a great job. And I think this is a crucial moment. And like Syria, like Libya, like Afghanistan, there's a long list of foreign policy problems that the Biden administration has ignored. And I think you can add the Balkans and the problems right now that we're seeing because of lack of Biden leadership.
Rick, as always, we appreciate your insight into Iran and, of course, your focus on the Balkans. We want to continue to update our audience on those kind of issues.